The scope of the modern telegraph and cable is worldwide. In America alone, 30,000 branch offices and agencies offer many opportunities for managers, operators, repairmen, and other trained personnel to render efficient service to the public. It's a far cry from present-day telegraph facilities, the early beginnings of the 19th century. Similarly, it's a far cry from the first telephone developed by Alexander Bell in 1875. In the early days, switchboards were operated by men, and service was crude. Today, modern facilities handle more than 100 million calls every 24 hours. These calls flow at the rate of 1,000 per second through a telephone network using enough wire to string a line to the sun more than 90 million miles away. This tremendous system provides job opportunities for 500,000 employees with a wide range of interests and capacities, from outdoor work with field crews to intricate research work in the experimental laboratory. To study these job opportunities, let's imagine that the town of Homeville is to receive a new and larger telephone exchange. First, the engineering department prepares the plans for the buildings and transmission systems and arranges for plant construction. Much of this technical work requires specialized training. Then, skilled craftsmen build lines, install equipment, and maintain it in operating order. After construction is completed, a large number of operators are brought in to staff the switchboard under the guidance of supervisors. These operators have been trained to provide courteous and speedy service. To be an operator, an applicant must have a clear voice, normal hearing, and eyesight. A high school education is an advantage. About 225,000 operators, the most important factor in efficient exchange service, are employed by all companies. They also handle all long distance and special calls. Even in communities served by dial telephone and automatic systems, many operators are required for information and special service. With the traffic personnel on hand, the new Homeville exchange is ready for full-scale operation. A clerical force is organized for computing charges for service, preparing and mailing bills, and collecting the money, as well as all other office work. Costs and income are analyzed, and statistics prepared for administrative purposes. Now, the new Homeville exchange is a unit of the worldwide telephone network. To supply this far-flung network with the latest improvements, research engineers in laboratories constantly experiment to discover new techniques, new materials, and quicker methods of production. The dial telephone and automatic switchboard are among the better known accomplishments of these skilled engineers. These are men who must possess the creative mind and an everlastingly curious approach. In addition, they are highly trained in scientific and technical fields. While a college education is helpful, a young man or woman can start in the telephone or telegraph industries after graduation from high school and work his or her way up. For technical work, an understanding of mechanical drawing, elementary electricity, physics, and mathematics is very important. All new employees in these industries are trained right on the job or in company schools to perform specific tasks. One of these special jobs is that of the lineman. His duty is to help build new lines and repair those which have been damaged. In the spring and summer, he fights storms of rain and wind. In the winter, there is ice, snow, and freezing gales. Opportunities in all jobs for promotion are plentiful because most companies prefer to advance their own personnel whenever possible. Dependability is an important factor in judging an applicant's aptitude. And just as the public depends on prompt service and communication, the telegraph and telephone companies, in turn, must depend upon reliable, capable employees to keep these nerve systems of our social and economic life functioning properly. Throughout the country, men and women can find excellent job opportunities in the twin fields of wire communication. These are jobs with stable employment for a wide range of aptitudes and ambitions. If you are the sort of person who finds satisfaction in contributing to the service of other people everywhere, then telephone or telegraph communication may become your life work.